looks like we have won the die roll, so we'll be on the play here. And this is a pretty easy keep. Yeah, this is just a beautiful hand, really. We get probably turn three algae Gario. Yeah, I'm just going to ramp here. So if this is the case, then we want to get this thing. It's a little awkward with the Azorius Chancery, but we probably will take next. Let's see what we draw, but it's reasonable to take next turn off to get the Chancery down, because then we can just play Etched Oracle with the mana available to crack it, which is a pretty big deal. Getting the Algae Gharial down next turn without any way to pump it or do anything isn't really that big of a deal. It won't be blocking, and we're going to be attacking for one. So it's probably better to just take the turn off to get the Chancery down to make sure that our Etched Oracle goes. Evolving Wilds is an interesting one, too. Yeah, let's just do that. Okay, so we're leaning pretty hard on this Etched Oracle, as you can see. The reason being that we've ramped out a bunch. We flooded a little bit here. Rampant Growth, land, and just two spells. So, you know, drawing three spells off of Etched Oracle is going to be a pretty big deal. Sphere. All right, well, our opponent's up to no good here as well, so. Oh, yeah. Multicolored fight. It's on. And I will claim my first victim here. I do need to not play Evolving Wilds here, though. Because I have to leave up a mana to be able to crack the Etched Oracle in case my opponent had some type of answer for it. It's just not acceptable to get an Evolving Wilds into play tap, just to get a tap land out of our hand, to give up the potential for our opponent just snapping off Etched Oracle and we don't get any value out of it. Especially given our hand, we're not really going into anywhere right now. Just Algae Gharial plus Alloy Mirror, which isn't going to win the game for us. Especially now that we know this. All right, so now that this has happened, our decision is a lot easier. We can just go ahead and crack this thing right now. Yeah, and give us some hope down the line. I think I'm still skipping the Evolving Wilds, though. Maybe I'm not. No, actually, I'm not. I'm going to play Alloy Mirror and an Evolving Wilds, and I'm going to play the Raise the Alarm as well. I really do want to get the ramp going here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We're just a couple away from getting Artisan down. And we're going to take a total beating from this Manta in the meantime. Was really hoping we'd draw a little better off the Oracle, but we did at least hit something big to cast with our mana. 5/5 Skyreach Manta, 2/2 Matka Riders. Well, that's such is life, I suppose. Okay, get rid of this. Probably need to get white here. Yes. And play Raise the Alarm. And Battle Grace. Well, that's why we got white. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. But we really need 9. To get Algae Gharial down as well. And just to get Artisan of Kozilek for that matter. Okay, well, we don't have it. So our choice is Algae Gareel or Battle Grace Angel, and I think it's I think we should just play the Battle Grace here. 2, 3, 4, 5 can play around Mana Leak if we play an untapped land, which I suppose I'll do. And then I think I just go ahead and attack with the Alloy Mirror here. I'd happily trade it off for both of these. And it hits for a healthy amount here, too. All right, go ahead. And then in kind of a strange ideal world, our opponent somehow kills the Battle Grace Angel using like a premium removal spell, freeing us up to play Artisan next turn to get it back. Because right now we don't actually have anything to get back with the Artisan, which is a little awkward. Could chump block. But that seems really terrible. Opponent is attacking, which indicates that they probably do have an answer to it, because right now they really can't race the Battle Grace Angel. I get to attack back for 5 here. Yeah, you got it. I'm not blocking. Maybe it's a bounce spell like a Aether Snipe or something. Which would be pretty good for them. Oh, it's just another one of these. All right, well, I can deal with this because I get to attack with Battle Grace. They'll probably trade it for Skyreach and then get it back with Artisan, which would be absolutely perfect. Oh, and we even drew a Dismember. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 mana. All right. Well, let's attack with Battle Grace. And secretly hope that my opponent blocks with Skyreach Manta, which they're definitely incentivized to do. And also, this looks normal from their perspective. Like, what am I going to do? Not attack with my Battle Grace? It doesn't block either 5/5, so I need to gain some life. All right, we're doing it. How sweet is that? My lord. We even have Dismember next turn and Algae Gareel. Sick. Nest Invader. Yes, Nest Invader resolves. Why did you do that? Oh, just to bolster up against Artisan, maybe? And then attack here. That makes sense. Oh. That's why. 5. Fiery Fall the Angel. That's fine. Our Arsene Kozilek is still going to do a good job here. And our Dread Drone and our Dismember. All right, so first things first, the truth arrives. And he's not messing around. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 1 mana for Dismember to take down the Skyreach Mantis still. Means that I can actually attack with Alloy Mirror here. Or no, I cannot attack with Alloy Mirror here, is what I should say. Actually, I can. I totally can. I can play Dread Drone, and I get to make the mana, the one colorless I need for Dismember with the Dread Drone. So yes, I will attack. I don't care if this trades even for a Nest Invader because it makes our Algae Gharreel that much bigger. Dread Drone. Kill that right now. Go ahead. Now getting through for 9 damage is an incredibly tall order. Getting through for, what did I lose, 4 there? So down to 5, down to 8, and then finishing from there is also very difficult, but more possible. So let's see, we're facing down the Skyreach Manta deck, so we want a Sundering Vitae. And maybe even a Plummet. We've already seen 2 Skyreach Mantas, so yeah, I'm going to bring in the Plummet as well. Do we see any enchantments? I don't think so. I'll kill the Kami. I don't think we're going to get ran over here. So it puts a little less pressure on those early cards. Flash Freeze. Flash Freeze, let's see, we saw a few things that it could counter. Some ultimately useless elementals, but also Fiery Fall was a big one there. I don't think we're going to have blue commonly enough, or nor is it worth it to really push in that direction. You know, we've got Simic Growth Chamber, we could run this, but yeah, I don't think that's worth it. I do like the Plummet, though. That does seem good. I think I'll cut just one of our more expensive cards. So that gives us Sundering Vitae and Plummet, which means that we should be well set up in case our opponent does have another Skyreach Manta, which we've already seen 2 of, and that is an issue. Gotta respect the Skyreach Manta. All right, what do we got? We got an easy keep. That's a good hand. We get guaranteed turn 3 Kozilek's Predator, which can turn into Scatter the Seeds pretty quickly too. We've got a Plummet in the hand in case our opponent has a similar draw to last time where they kind of curve right into, you know, some big Skyreach Manta or whatever. Oh, and then we even drew the truth. All right, so we need black mana, but we also will need another green at some point, though not realistically soon, because scatter we can use Convoke anyway. So I think I just get the color that we don't have here. Yeah, and then next turn I'm just going to play the Predator, which should shore up the ground game. I mean, even though we're on the draw, our start is much more powerful. This Soulbright Flamekin is not going to be, a solid avenue to victory in this matchup. So I'm actually pretty happy that that's what our opponent started things off with. Yeah, and it looks like they have no other play here either, so this is pretty great. Whoop, 4 colors. Yeah. Just get predatorial here. This sets up the best plays for us. Algae Gharreel. If we hit a land, we could, if it's a forest, we could do Algae Gharreel and scatter, which is pretty nice. Even just without it, we've got Algae Gharreel with 2 Eldrazi spawn tokens, which is pretty great. And we hit the land anyway. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Truth. And this lets us cast Scatter the Seeds in our most efficient mode. Is Plague Rusalka as well? Yeah. Yeah, how do you like this? Not bad at all. I will just wait a turn, though, because I am going to prioritize getting Scatter the Seeds down here. Then we can start mowing things down with Plague Drusalka. It just gets ugly from here. Opponent can make a 4-4 flyer. If they do, we'll secretly just be happy about it. Mecha Riders did just become a 3-3, which is a thing. All right. Best case scenario. Wow. We even drew the swamp. Yeah, this turn is just going to be stupid. So, I think I kill. All right, well, that's happening. And then I can attack with this, and this. Actually, I think what I want to do here is just get this thing done now. And then this thing's a 3-3, so I can actually just attack with everything, and if he blocks anything, I can sack the other two of these or whatever. So let's attack like this. I don't want to let him trade for the Plague Drusalka, though it could be important. We don't really have anything else to cast here, so let's trade those off. You take 10. And people ask me why I call this card the truth. People have the audacity to ask me that question. He's Tribal Flames himself. Yeah. Yeah, well, some people aren't ready to face the truth. It's hard to blame the guy. All right, so that's it. Smashing. We'll see you guys in the second round.